All right, you made it to pilot training, or you're paying for it. So what next? Stick with us on Flywire. I'm going to give you the three-bag theory of being a fighter pilot. Something like that. Hey, I'm Scott Perdue, and today on Flywire, since we already defined the fighter pilot mindset and established rule number one, I've got a short one for you today. So let's move on to the next stage in our path, okay? Everyone carries baggage around with them, even if they don't realize it, and we gotta fill some bags. It's kind of like Bob Marley. You forge the chains of your life as you go through it, and you end up carrying or dragging all that around with you as you go through life. So what I wanna talk about is the three bag theory, okay? That's the clue bag, the bag of luck, and finally the bag of hard knocks. Not necessarily in that order. Everyone has these bags as a matter of nature. What's in them at any one time is largely up to you. Of course, I'm talking from the Air Force fighter pilot perspective, and I'm sure the Navy has a similar idea. Probably has something to do with water. So there's some crossover between the bags, sorta, kinda, and I guess I'll explain that in a minute. But when you enter the wide world on your own, your bag of luck is usually full. There are some that somehow missed picking up that bag, and in a former life, these folks were known as sad sacks. Not good to be one of those. I'd be willing to bet you've met a few of these guys in your life. One thing about the bag of luck is that you have to be careful about it. If you use it a lot, you never know how much is left in it. And like Schrödinger's cat, you can't know until you open it to look inside. You just don't know how much is there. So be careful. For some reason, most folks don't start filling their clue bag in high school, and a lot of college students miss that exercise as well, especially those who went to the academy. Just a little shot there. I hope you can forgive me, but some of these shots, I know they're cheap, but you know, they're dessert. I mean, maybe they're dessert. Seriously, your clue bag is empty when you start, wherever you start from. So there you are, a college graduate, and your job is to learn to fly. What happens next? Well, when you walk into the classroom, hopefully you have your eyes and ears open and you can start to fill the clue bag. You do that by studying, knowing the Dash 1, the flying rigs, general knowledge, various aviation facts and figures, weather, you name it, there's all kinds of stuff to know. All of that fills your clue bag. And since you're human as well, I presume that you are, and that you have a tendency to forget stuff you learned and you don't use very much. It means you need to keep studying, keep learning, and pretty much forever. Things you hear from others, techniques, facts, ideas, perspectives, and most of all, their experiences can help fill your clue bag. The thing is you gotta keep at it to keep it full. There's a saying that your clue bag or your brain is like an iceberg, and ideas, knowledge, stuff like that are like penguins. And at some point when you add a new penguin to the iceberg, the oldest ones fall off the end of the iceberg. The important thing is try to keep the most important penguins on the iceberg. The bag of hard knocks can also be called the bag of experience. The H&K bag, whatever you want to call it, is like the clue bag. It's empty when you start. And if you're like most, stuff really doesn't go into that bag unless you experience it firsthand. And that usually means something bad's happened to you. When you're on your own and sweating out of flight training, you start to fill your H&K bag. Everything you experience goes into that bag. Sometimes you forget what went in, and sometimes something weird comes back out of the bag. In other words, experience can be really good, but it can also be really bad. Knowing just when to trust it is the key. And that is another thing that comes out of the H&K bag. How about that? Just so you understand how these bags work, when you find yourself in a tight situation, maybe life-threatening, you have to rely on resources. The resources you carry around with you are your three bags, the three-bag theory. There are times and mechanical failures where the stuff in the H&K bag isn't enough to keep you away from the cliff. The shit has hit the proverbial fan. What you want to do is reach into the clue bag and pull out a solution to your predicament. After all, you've been working hard at keeping that clue bag full, and somewhere in there is the clue to help you out here, right? The last bag you have is your bag of luck. The question you have to ask yourself is, how many times have you reached into that bag? And do you feel lucky today? Remember, you have no idea how much luck is left in that bag until you try and pull some of it out. Don't run out. I'm a big believer in the no drama idea. I've found that drama is the hallmark of someone burning through their bag of luck. I don't want to be that guy. I've said that it's better to be lucky than good, and what that means is sometimes shit happens and you have no control over or input. good or not. It has to happen to you, and the point is it's good to be lucky. I know this, but I try and mitigate some of that risk of being out of luck. So I keep my clue bag full, as full as I can, and pay attention to my H&K bag. My hard knocks bag keeps me in the low drama lane. There is a famous Frank Borman saying, a superior pilot uses a superior judgment to avoid situations which require the use of a superior skill. Judgment comes from the bag of hard knocks. I said earlier that there is some crossover between bags. That is true particularly with the clue bag and the HK bag. They tend to add and subtract from the other bag in unexpected ways. People don't know how that works, but they aren't the same resource, but sometimes they can be mistaken for the one for the other. On the other hand, the bag of luck is like a sieve. You just don't know how it's doing. Sometimes the good stuff is going in the HK bag and can refill a little bit. Sometimes the same thing happens with the clue bag, helping the bag of luck, but it's not consistent and you can't rely on it. My rule of thumb is to treat that bag like it's flat. A lot of folks seem to think that luck is bottomless. And maybe it is for them, but it's not for most. All of this ties back into the fighter pilot mindset. Do the work, keep trying to get better, acknowledge your mistakes, and work at filling your bags. I'm not going to describe the nitty-gritty details of pilot training. When I went through UPT, you had to do air math. GPS didn't exist, and we figured out how much fuel we had in seconds of burner time. For the most part, we still managed to find our way. But, you know, that's then. This is now. If you're paying your own way through flight training, the bags all work the same, but it's harder to fill them up. In the military, the system is like a fire hose directed right at you, and part of the test can be you keep breathing. The civilian route is fly often enough so you can fill your bags without them leaking out between flights. You can do it. It just might be harder. You gotta keep your eye on the prize. I've got one other nickel to throw in the grass for y'all, and that is beware of social media. Life is messy for everybody. If you live out your life online for all the world to see, it basically never goes away. You're never gonna have a chance to start over, to get past a dumb mistake or a stupid comment. I'm not saying to stay off Facebook or Instagram, but have a policy about what you put out there. The reality is that no one really cares about you anyway, and unless they can use your dumb stuff to hurt you, that's out there. And I guarantee you, someone's gonna try to do that. This is where C.W. Moyne's thing says, don't be a douche, would really come into play, among other situations. Don't be a douche and put your crap on Facebook. So I hope you liked the video. If you did, hit like and subscribe. Looks like this here. I'd like to thank my Patreon supporters here. Without y'all, these videos would be harder to do. If you'd like to support the channel, I'll leave a link to the Flywire Patreon page down below. Meanwhile, keep tabs on your bag, because no one else will. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time on Flywire. All right, you made it to pilot training. All right, you made it to pilot training.